question is, what is the scientific evidence that meat and milk are bad for you? Anyone who wants the scientific evidence should read the book, The China Study, which has a lot of research and a lot of references. So you can get all the scientific evidence just in one place. But today, let's talk about the logical evidence. If you look at any animal, every animal eats according to instinct. Let's think about our instincts. If we were on a farm or an orchard and we see fruits and vegetables, what do you feel like doing? Picking and eating, of course, right? These are our foods. But if you were to see a chicken walk by, or a goat or a cow, does your mouth water? Probably not, right? Any animal who's a carnivore or an omnivore would pounce on the chicken, tear it apart and eat it whole. Skin, bones, beak, claws, everything, and that too in the raw form. But we can't do that. We aren't actually omnivores, but we have learned to eat all of this, and this is our conditioning. We think that it's good for us. It's the same with milk. Every baby loves their mother's milk. This is a natural food for us. But if you were to give a baby cow's milk, every baby refuses. It's not our food, but we have learned to have this. And when I say milk, I mean milk, cheese, butter, cream, curds, ice cream, everything that's made from milk. This is not our food. So the real evidence is, if you take away all these foods from our diet, then over a period of time, diseases will disappear. All these lifestyle diseases, diabetes and hypertension and heart disease, these are diseases that we are the authors of. We are the authors of our disease and the author of our health. And we can change our health destiny just by changing our food. If you don't believe this, try it just for 3 months. Take out all the meat and milk from your diet and see what happens to your health. It's worth trying. And if we go closer to the kind of foods we're supposed to eat, that means plant-based, whole, and organic, health is just our destiny.